go.
Okay, Ron, of course, last ball game of the regular season for the Redskins tonight, they come in with a record of 9-0, undefeated on the year. Highland comes in with a 7-2 record. And ought to be a good ball game tonight in captain's for the Redskins, number 83, David Williams. And where they turn sideways so I can see the others. We getting ready to kick this down. Number 77, Alex Phillips. One of the other captains, and number 78, Sean Smith, is the other captain.
With the opening kickoff in just one moment. Y'all stay tuned to Redskins football. And as the Redskins get ready to come out.
And Rondy, I didn't get to see the toss.
We're going to receive, Gary.
To receive, so the Redskins down in the end zones. And here come the Pocahontas Redskins for the last regular season game of the year against the Highland Rebels onto the field. And we're at Highland, and as always, it's cold, cold weather. We said all year long it would be cold, didn't we?
It sure did.
And it certainly is, as the wind's blowing around, let's say, 15 to 20 miles an hour out of the north, and temperature is probably right around, I'd say, below 40, but it's supposed to drop in the low 30s, or maybe even in the 20s tonight. But 2 years ago, and I think a lot of people remember being over here, it was around 20 to 23 degrees, I believe, according to where you were at here, but around 23 degrees, I believe, in Hardy that night. So this is nothing unusual for all the Redskin fans. And you can see over there, Ron, a lot of Redskin fans over there. They've got the sidelines lined all the way down, and what stands that are over there is completely full.
Yes, I'll tell you what, they're completely full tonight, folks.
And the Redskins,
they're still lined up back behind us, Gary.
That's right. There's a pretty good lineup still. Have not gotten in the gates yet. I think a lot of people waiting for the last minute to come, but if you kind of get dressed for it, it's kind of like duck hunting. If you kind of get dressed for it, it's not too bad.
It's not too bad.
And I think I've got on just about everything I own that's warm.
You and me both.
But we're getting ready to kick this thing off as the Redskins are going to receive to start the ball game. As here's the kickoff. It's going to be a low kick, and it's going to be taken by number 41, Brent Reynolds, and we're trying to return down the left side. He's to the 10, and pull down there at about the 11-yard line. Number 41, Brent Reynolds, on the return, gets it back to the, about the 12. So first down and 10 for the Redskins. It's 12-yard line. And one interesting note about this ball game is Redskins, of course, coming in, have already clinched a share of the conference championship and can win it outright tonight. But Highland not going to the playoffs. As give to Martin up the middle, and Martin's going to get a couple. But Highland has two conference losses. They've lost to Middleton and last week to Corning, 7-6. So Highland's out of the playoff picture. Redskins, like I say, have clinched, they share the conference championship, and we'll be moving on to the playoffs next week. And we'll be playing at home next week. We're not sure, completely sure who it'll be, but we believe it'll be Nashville. Fairly certain. Second down and 8 for the Redskins. Chester on the option, and Chester cuts it up. And Chester's going to be dropped after a gain of maybe a yard. Number 34, Casey Chester, starting at quarterback tonight for the Redskins in their option tight offense. Third down, and well, let's call it 8. It's closer to 8 yards. And the line of scrimmage is about the 13-yard line. So Redskins like to convert here and keep this ball moving on down as Chester, number 34, Casey Chester, is the quarterback. Chester on the option play. Chester keeps it, cuts it up. And Chester is going to be stopped short of the first down as he gets it out to about the 18 or 19-yard line. So the Redskins are going to be forced to punt here on their first possession of the game. Line of scrimmage is, let's call it about the 18. Fourth down and 3. Number 33, Shane Martin, standing on his own 4-yard line. Now moves up to the 5. Number 14, Zach Wellman, the snapper. A low snap, but Martin gets a good punt away. And the punt's going to hit and going to go out of bounds on about the 47-yard line. So Highland will take over first down and 10 from their own 47.
Tell you what, this is the last game. We'd like to thank those sponsors out there. A lot of folks out there has helped bring these games back to y'all, and you need to thank them.
If you haven't already, you need to
thank them.
Like I said, they've done an excellent job, the boys have this year.
Certainly have.
We're proud of them, both of
them. And this season's not over. This is the last regular season, but the playoffs start next week. As Highland, first down and 10. Back to pass is the quarterback being rushed. Now he passes, it's going to be knocked down on a good defensive play by number 10, Stephen Malone. And he was getting a heat from, I know McFall, and there was another Redskin in there. May have been Fears, I'm not sure. But the quarterback was getting a heat that time, and he threw it, I think, a little bit quicker, but Malone broke on the ball and made a good play as Highland. Now was second down, and you're hearing a lot of wind. And
a lot of wind.
On the tape, that's because there is a lot of wind up here.
We're up here.
Probably 20 mile an hour at least. Second down and 10 for Highland. Gives the tailback, and he is near the broke. Now he breaks it outside. He's nearly stopped at the line, but he breaks it outside, close to a first down. For 24, Sisto makes the tackle on a little counter play, and he's very close to the first down. They may have to measure, and that's what they're going to do. They're going to measure for the timeout, for the first down.
We'll take a timeout.
Third down.
Third down, and about a half a yard to go for a first down. And quarterback sneak, and he's going to be close. I believe he's going to have it, but he didn't get much. If he got the first down, he didn't get much more than that. Let's see. Yeah, they give him a spot for it. I believe he's got it this time. And he does. So Highland picks up the first down. And the line of scrimmage down at the 43-yard line of the Redskins. Just opened the ball game, 8:55 to go. Redskins had to punt on their first possession from their own 18-yard line. Highland started from their own 47, and there's the Redskin 43. Gives the tailback, and he's hit, and now gets loose, and he's all the way down to the 37. And Redskins almost had him back there, just like the other one. Well, even more so on this particular play, but he's able to slip through the tackles. And I'm sure the Redskins will improve on their tackling there a little bit. That they were there, just couldn't make the play.
Couldn't make the play.
This second down, and about four for Highland. Ball at the 37 of the Redskins. Get to the fullback, and he is popped hard. He gets maybe down to the 36. So it's going to be third down. Third down and about about two. Tackle made by 33 Martin. Defensively for the Redskins, number 24, Brandon Sisco. Into the safety, 34, Casey Chester at the other safety. The cornerbacks, 32, Chad Tiedemeyer, and 10, Stephen Malone. Linebackers, 44, Craig Baltz, 33, Shane Martin. We'll get the defensive line for you. Third down and three. Quarterback still with the ball. Now he pitches it, and he's trying to get outside, and there's a fumble on the play, and it goes out of bounds, and it's still Highland's ball, and it's probably going to be enough for a first down as he fumbled the ball out of bounds, and it probably worked to Highland's advantage as it's going to be, I believe, enough for a first down, and it is. So another first down for Highland is there down at the 33, and try to set the defensive line for you. Number 55, Kevin Mason, in at one of the defensive ends. And number 51, Chris Hinkle, in on the defensive front. Number 40, Jerry Fears. Number 81, John McFall, the other defensive end. And they didn't get the other down lineman. Give to the fullback, and he is cut down on a good tackle by number 51, Chris Hinkle. And Hinkle just shot through there and dropped him for no gain. So second down and 10, line of scrimmage to 33 of the Redskins. Highland with the ball, their first possession of the ball game. 7:04 left to go in the first quarter. No score, but Highland with the ball at the Redskins 33-yard line. penalty flags on the play. And let's see who that's going to be on this before the play starts. It's going to be against the Rebels. So a good break for the Redskins there as it backs Highland up 5 yards. And this is down in the area where every inch counts.
Every inch counts here.
It's back to the 37. It'll be second down and 15. From the Redskin 37-yard line. Last ball game, last regular season game of the year. The Redskins undefeated on the year, 9-0, trying to go perfect. But with a tough Highland team here tonight. Back to pass is the quarterback, Ben Rush. And the screen now is going to be knocked down. And he was hammered hard, the quarterback, number 61, Chad Benson. And the screen didn't work as number 40, Jerry Fears, is in our 51, Hinkle. As that was a, that's what you call a middle screen. It's where the quarterback just dropped straight back with the ball. And let's have the fullback. Just kind of stayed right in there, and the line kind of gets in front of him, and they hopefully get the ball at fullback, and it lets the defensive front come on through. So they've got all their linemen to block, and it's a good play when it works.
That's right.
That time the Redskins, they smelled it out real well.
That they did.
So third down and 15, a big defensive play for the Redskins. They can hold here. Third down, back to pass is the quarterback. And now he runs, now he throws it. It's going to be dropped. Dropped out on the 4-yard line as covering back there, Chester 34 and 24 Cisco. But he had the receiver open, and he put the pass there. The pass just wouldn't come. As a good route by the receiver and a good pass by the quarterback, and the Redskins really dodged a bullet right there. As that would have been, that one would have been for 6 points.
That it would.
So fourth down now for Highland. And the line of scrimmage, the 37-yard line, they're in punt formation. In punt formation, there's the snap, big rush, and does get the punt away. That's going to go in the end zone, so a good break for the Redskins. It's going to come out to the 20. So the Redskins will start from their own 20-yard line, first down and 10. First down and 10 for the Redskins, their own 20. Yeah, Martin, and Martin's still going. Martin's trying to get outside, and he does, and Martin's up to the 30-yard line and across the 30 to about the 31 or 32-yard line. Number 33, Shane Martin, on a good, hard run. Martin picks up the first down. A 13-yard pickup for Shane Martin, and the Redskins get their first down of the ball game here with 6:05. 6:05 to go in the first quarter. First down and 10. And Chester still with the ball. Chester cuts it up and gets to the 39. Number 34, Casey Chester, with a quarterback keeper on the option play, and gets the 39. Be second down. Yeah. And about three. So second and three as number 10, Stephen Malone, comes wide to the right. And Chester give to Martin, and Martin is cut down after a gain of a couple. He's going to get close to the first down, but he's going to be a little short. Let's call it third down and a yard for the first down. He is, let's see, across the 40 to the 42. It's a short yard, but it's third down. Number 70, Nick Wallace, is in at the center. We'll set the entire line for you. Give up the middle to Martin, and Martin's got the first down, and he's all the way down to the, got the 49. No, they're going to mark it on the 50. So he's to midfield, Shane Martin.
Excellent.
They mark it down just inside the 50-yard line. And number 34, Casey Chester, and a quarterback. Chester still with the ball. Now Chester pitches to Cisco. Ball's on the ground, and I don't know who come up with it. I believe the Redskins have, and they do. The 24 Cisco was able to come up with it. Fumble on the option there, and the Redskins were able to come up with it. So let's, El Highland thought they had come up with it, but the Redskins still got the ball. And the loss is back to about the 47-yard line. Second down play now for the Redskins. Chester with the ball. Chester outside, and Chester now gets away. Now Chester cuts it down the outside. Chester to the 50. Chester to the 40. 35 and down to the 34-yard line. Casey Chester, about a 7 or 8 yard loss into a big gainer as he's all the way down to the inside the 35 of Highland. And an excellent run by number 34, Casey Chester, and that was nothing but all on his own. He did get a good block out here on this side. And a lot of time we miss, I'm watching the ball carry, and I miss those good blocks. And normally when we're just watching the ball game, you see those, but we're trying to see where he goes and everything. But you can watch that tape and see who made that good block. First and 10 from just inside the 35, ball on the ground. And I'm not sure Highland may have come up with it, and they have. And Highland comes up with the ball down at the 36-yard line of Highland.
Bad break.
So a bad break for the Redskins. Highland with 3:25 to go in the first quarter, no score. Back to pass the quarterback, and it's complete, and he is hit hard by the Redskins. Number 32, Chad Telemeyer, the first man there. Number 61, Chad Vincent, also in on the play, along with Baltz and Martin. And pass was complete for about a 4-yard pickup, as he was Chad attacked out there just as soon as he caught the ball.
That he was.
And 39-yard line is the line of scrimmage. We suck it down and 7. Second 7 for Highland from their own 39. Ball's on the ground, and let's see who come up with it. I believe Highland has recovered it. And Highland does come up with the ball. And Pete Bounds, number 64, is the down lineman I missed there a while ago on the defensive front. 61, Chad Benson, and then at the defensive end, I can't hardly talk them, but freeze up.
And I feel they won't blame you, Gary, if you do. I'll tell you what, it's awful cool up here tonight.
Number 81 to fall at the other defensive end. Hinkle, Beers, and Bounds, the down lineman. Martin and Baltz, the linebackers. Third down and 8 for Highland. Quarterback still with the ball. He's hit hard in the backfield, and he does get it off. He does get the handoff, but he's immediately dropped by a host of the Redskins in their Hinkle. 64 Bounds also in there. So third down. We'll make it fourth down. Fourth down at about 8. Line of scrimmage to 38-yard line. So the Redskins should come up with a little better field position they've had the last first two possessions. Chester standing back on his own 22. And there's the snap. And it's a long kick away, and Chester's going to field this one on the 16-yard line. And Chester trying to get around the outside, and not going to be able to do it. And he's down to the 20. And that was a good defensive play by one of the Highland players, as he fought off 2 blocks to bring Chester down. Chester trying to get around those blocks, just wasn't able to do it. And it's cold, cold, cold.
Cold, cold, cold is the word.
A typical Highland game, as we've said all year. We knew it'd be cold when this game came up.
We were up here 2 years ago, and it
at least
cold.
It's not raining.
Oh, that's true.
Like it was last week. The Redskins now up to the line. First down and 10 from their own 20. Chester still in at quarterback. The pitch out the left side to Cisco. Cisco's around the corner, and Cisco's down the sideline. He's at 45 and knocked out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. Number 24, Brandon Cisco. And boy, somebody made a fantastic block over there. If you're if you got your VCR going, run that back and look at that one. Somebody annihilated one of the Highland Rebels over there on that run and give Cisco about 15 more yards on the play. It's out to the 42-yard line, first down and 10, but a good block out there on the corner, on the sideline, really broke Cisco loose over there. Give to Martin, and Martin is tripped up for no gain. Offensive line, we'll try to set Alex Phillips, number 77, and our number 70, Nick Wallace, is in at the center. Number 52 is in at a right guard. I'm not sure. He may be at a tackle. Mike Emmons. Yeah, Emmons is in at right tackle. They suck it down and 10. Pitch out to Cisco. Cisco going around the right side, and Cisco cuts it up. Cisco to 40, the 35, 30, and down to the 28-yard line. And a good run by Brandon Cisco as he broke it around this side that time and was able to get all the way down to the 29-yard line of Highland. And Martin leading the way that time, and Martin may have been the one who made that block on the far side.
Yeah, well,
he's the lead blocker on that play.
We got some key blockers out there tonight doing a fantastic job.
But a good run by Cisco moves it down to the 28-yard line with 44 seconds to go in the first quarter. No score. And this is the farthest the Redskins have been down in Highland territory. And they'd like to move it on down and punch it in. Give to Martin at the middle, and Martin is dropped at about the 25, just a little shy of the 25. Number 12, Jeremy Presley checks in. 83, David Williams checks out. And Redskins just going to let the clock run down here in the first quarter, and we'll be back with the second quarter with no score between the Rebels of Highland and our Pocahontas Redskins.
And thank those sponsors. Y'all stay tuned to more Pocahontas Redskins football in just one moment. Pocahontas Redskins football, second quarter.
Here to start second quarter, Redskins with the ball down on the 25-yard line. Pitch out to Cisco, and Cisco nearly caught. Now he gets around, now he cuts it up, and the ball's on the ground. And Highland comes up with the ball as the ball was stripped away, and Highland was able to come up with it. So another turnover for the Redskins down on Highland's end of the field, and the Redskins come up empty as Highland recovers the fumble just outside their own 25-yard line. No score in the ball game. Just started the second quarter, and a cold, cold night. That ball's got to be, it's got to be like carrying a rock out there, I'm sure. As we've seen a lot of fumbles already tonight. As we told you earlier, the wind's going 15 to 20 miles an hour, probably even gusting more than that, and real cold. Give to the fullback, and he's gone nowhere. Tackled by Martin. And 61, Chad Vinson also in there. And number 64, Pete Brown, getting up off the bottom of the pile. And the defensive front has done that time and time again this year. Don't believe we've had any teams to really run on the Redskins up the middle, not really run anywhere, but the defense has played well all year long.
Yes, they have.
So it's second down now, and let's call it nine. Tail back with the ball, he's hit just immediately. And I believe it was number 81, John McFall, the first Redskin there. He had plenty of help coming in. Number 60, Brian Jansen, checks in. And with the wind blowing, I hope you can kind of tell a little bit of what we're trying to tell you. I hear a little bit of it. They're about to freeze up here. It's going to be third down now, so big play for Redskins if they can hold here. Highland with the ball, third and eight. Back to pass this quarterback. He's going to be sacked. Number 64, Pete Bounds. Also in there, Chad Benson, but Bounds, number 64, is a man that got him all the way back on the 20-yard line.
Bounds bounding real good, didn't he?
So Bounds comes up with a big play for the Redskins. Big play for the Redskins, number 64, Pete Bounds. And Pete's had an excellent year for the Redskins. So So fourth down. And about 15 yards for first down. And there's a high snap. It's going to go over the punter's head. It's going to be a safety. And the Redskins are going to come up with 2 points as the snap went over the punter's head into the end zone. So the Redskins score 2 points and didn't even have the ball. That's pretty good defense.
Pretty good. That's a great defense.
We were just bragging on the defense, and the defense scored 2 points and didn't even have to touch the ball.
That they did.
Now, that very well could have been in all probability. It seemed like their punter is standing about 15 yards deep, I believe. Next time they punt, we'll count it. But he's standing deeper than a normal punter. And that time, it almost looked like as the ball was going up, you know, was coming to him, it almost looked like the wind got in there, just blew it too high and he couldn't reach it.
Couldn't do anything with it.
But what that means is the Redskins get 2 points on the safety, so they lead the ball game 2-0. And Highland now gets a free kick. Purcell elects a kickoff from the 20 with the win. So the Redskins should get the ball in good field position, and I know they would like to take the ball down and score with it.
That they would.
As they've been down on Highland's end of the field down. Well, the one fumble was down on the 25, and I believe the other one was right around the 30, 31-yard line. So Highland set, and Redskins are set to receive the free kick. And the kick's going to come to number 10, Malone. And Malone now comes up with it. Now Malone's down the sideline, and say he stepped out of bounds on the 43. So the Redskins will take over first down and 10 from their own 43. Number 10, Stephen Malone on the return. Okay, the Redskins with the ball now. Number 14, Jack Wellman in at quarterback. And Wellman turns, hands the ball to Martin, and penalty flags, and I don't really know what the deal there was. Because apparently there was an early whistle. It's going to be on the Redskins. And illegal procedure.
Going to push it back five.
So it'll be first down at 15 yards. Number 62, Brian Perry, in on the offensive line. Number 60, Brian Jansen at a left guard. Perry to left tackle. Number 70, Nick Wallace is the center. And now we got another penalty flag. Let's see what this one's going to be. It's before the play started. And it's going to be against Highland, lined up in the neutral zone. So Redskins get the five yards back. Come on, ref, it's cold up here.
It's cold. We got a game to get on.
What's that? Martin and Cisco in the backfield. Chester in the slot. Malone split wide right. Back to pass is Wellman. Pass is complete to Chester. He gets around one man and gets around another and still is able to pick up a couple of yards after a lot of moves over there by number 34, Casey Chester. He was able to get a couple. So it'll be second down and eight. Ball just inside the 45-yard line of the Redskins. 9 minutes left in the first half. Redskins lead the ball game 2-0. Brady 3, David Williams split wide to the near side. And Wellman with the ball. Back to pass is Wellman. Wellman's pass way down the field, and it's going to be broken up. And Chester is down there also, number 41, Brent Reynolds. But the pass is broken up on about the 32-yard line.
With over 20
hits to the scoring, it's on a cold, cold, windy night here at Highland. And Zach Wilman, 14, got the offense set on third and eight. Back to pass, pass is coming incomplete. Number 12, Jeremy Presley, almost came up with it. Pass a little behind Presley, but and Presley unable to come down with it. So the Redskins going to have to put the ball away here as the offense just couldn't get it going that time. And Martin has set the punt. And Martin's got it. And Martin gets a high punt away. Good coverage down there. Fair catch call for it. And made that on the 22-yard line. So Highland will take over first and 10 from their own 22. Okay, Highland with the ball. First and 10 from their own 22. Quarterback still with the ball. Now he pitches. The pitch goes wide. He does catch it. And he's going to be tackled there. Martin, Malone. And also 44 Craig Balls in on the play. As it looked like the pitch was going to go wild, and the Highland running back made a good play to come down with the ball. And he did pick up a little more than a yard. Let's call it a yard. So second and 9 at the 23 of Highland. 8 minutes and 5 seconds left in the first half. Highland up to the line, gives the fullback, and he's hit hard by host of the Redskins. We're 64 bounds, and as we said before, you can almost make a recording. It's all he was able to kind of spin around and get across the 25. This will be third down and a long 7 for Highland. As they put receivers wide to both sides of the field. Third and 7. Back to pass is the quarterback. Pass over the middle. It's going to be incomplete. Ball's covering an arrow on the 40 here. But thrown right in the area there. Just a little quick pass with the linebacker. Ball's played it well. The 24, Ralph Collier, checks in. As it's fourth down. And we'll see what happens on this one. Okay, now he's lined at 5, 10, he's 13 yards deep this time. He didn't look like he's quite as deep. They kick it all the way down the 41-yard line and be dead there. So take over first down and 10 from their own 41. And from their own 41, 14, Zach Wellman, and the quarterback, good to Martin. And nowhere going as the middle completely stopped up that time by Highland. No gain on the play.
Redskins recover. It's a second down and 10.
Second and 10 for the Redskins. Ball just outside their own 40-yard line. 6:35 to go in the first half. Redskins lead the ball game 2-0. Has a little equipment problem there. And then officials working on it for one of the Highland players. As we said, next week, the Redskins have already been assured of a playoff. And regardless of the outcome of this game, the Redskins will go in as the first-place team. And we'll be playing at home next week against the winner in the 7AA South. Pitch out right side to Cisco, and Cisco trying to get around. Now he cuts it up. And Cisco is still on his feet. He's down to the 35-yard line. And a good run by Brandon Cisco, number 24. And, boy, you can really see that speed of Cisco's as he broke it through there and got it all the way to the 35. Now what the Redskins need to do, they need to capitalize on after a good run like that. They need to, move it on down and punch this ball in to wind up this first half. As that pitch on the corner has worked 3 times real well. Fumble on the play, and I believe the Redskins do recover as Wellman is able to get on it. And
I would imagine right now those hands are real numb, as cool as it is. The ball's hard to handle. Like you said, it's as hard as a brick.
Yeah, I'm sure it is. Redskins, though, they have had a little tendency to fumble this year. Of course, they played a couple ball games in real bad weather. Rain. This time pitch out to Cisco. Cisco cuts it up. Now he's brought down on about the 31. Looked like he might have had a little bit more running room, but running hard is number 24, Brandon Cisco, and doing a good job for the Redskins as he picks up about 4 on the play. It'll be 3rd and 6. So a big 3rd down play for the Redskins as they would like to convert here, and move the chains on down closer to that goal line. 62 Ryan Perry. In at the left tackle is Wellman, a set at quarterback. Wellman pitch out to Cisco. Cisco cuts it up. And he's going to get maybe a yard, but no more.
Cisco on the clear for the Redskins.
So it's going to be fourth down and five. And Redskins, I'm sure right here in this situation, well, I'm going to go for it. 4:39 to go in the half. And I know they'd like to convert right here. This is kind of a do-or-die situation. As fourth down, and Martin is the only back in the backfield. Martin is in motion, back to pass. Pass is intercepted. And brought down there. Pass is intercepted and brought back to the 38-yard line. And the Redskins unable to convert on the fourth down, and Highland takes over with 4:12 left to go in the first half. Okay, Highland up to the line now. First down and 10 from their own 38. Give to the tailback, and he is loose. He gets across the 45. Finally brought down there by number 34, Casey Chester, 44 balls. That's a pickup of about 7 yards on the play. The second down and three.
Look at the second down three.
And the Redskin defense has been on the field quite a bit, as Highland has moved the ball a little better than I thought they would, but they only really had one serious threat. Give to the fullback, and the fullback is outside, and he's across the 45, or down close to the 45, penalty flag on the play. Penalty flag thrown right in the direction of the run, so you know what that usually indicates.
Slipping in the backfield.
Usually indicates on the offense. As thrown in the direction of the run, that's what we got to hold against Highland. That's going to back it up. With 3:11 to go in the first half, Redskins lead this ball game 2-0. The only points on a safety. And the ball's going to be moved all the way back to the 36-yard line of Highland. Second down and 14 yards to go for a first down. Ball at the Highland 36-yard line. Give to the tailback, and the tailback's outside, and he is finally hit and brought down, but not after he picks up a big portion of that 14 yards. Spears and Telemeyer, and also 44, Craig Ball on the tackle. And it's going to be third down and four, a short four for Highland, as the ball carrier picked up a major portion of that. Major portion as the cold wind blows up here. 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the first half. Highland with the ball, third down, and a long three. And that was a give to the tailback, and tailback is outside, and he's going to be finally knocked out of bounds over there by 24 Cisco, but he picks up the first down. And the line of scrimmage is going to be about the 44 of the Redskins. So first down for Highland here with 2 minutes and 3 seconds to go in the first half. They're in Redskin territory.
That's the first time they've been down in about the 40-yard line tonight.
Yeah, they've been down there a couple of times, but here to close the first half in Highland, I think back to that drop pass. If they dropped on the floor earlier, this would have been a different ball game right now. Back to pass is the quarterback. Pass out in the flat and incomplete, covering over number 10, Stephen Malone. But that time, that was, you could almost see it in the action of the quarterback. He was nervous. He knew that defensive squad was coming after him and really threw the ball way early. The quarterback quarterback let go of the ball quite a bit too early that time. But credit to defensive front, because they've been in there only when he has tried to pass. Second down and 10. And this time offside against Highland as they jump early. And that's exactly what it was. That's going to move the ball back to the 48-yard line. Be second and 15 for the Rebels. 2 minutes to go in the first half. The Redskins lead it 2-0. And Drew Percy, I'm a little surprised at the score.
That I am.
You wouldn't think in a game like this it would be high scoring, but neither team is really really threatened. Second down, 15. Give the tailback, and he's immediately dropped. The number 33, Martin. 81 McCall in there, but and also number 64, Pete Downs. But a loss on the play back to the 47. So it'll be third down, and let's see, third and about third and 19.
It'll be third down and 17.
Well, let's see, five. Oh, that's not too good. About 16, Scully. Third and 16 for Highland with a minute 25 to go. Line of scrimmage, Highland 43-yard line. Gives the tailback, and he is, ball is loose, and Redskins can't get to it as Highland comes up with it back on the 45-yard line. And now Redskins motion their ball, but I think they probably had blown it dead. And they did, back on the 44. So Highland does retain possession of it with a minute 12 to go. This is going to be fourth down and a mile to go.
Yes, that's true.
It's going to be, let's see, 5, 10, 12, 13, 23 yards. Fourth and 23. High snap again. This time he does catch it. And he marks the punt and goes out of bounds on the 49-yard line. So the Redskins come up with the ball with 56 seconds left to go in the first half, right at midfield. First and 10, and the ball just shy of midfield. Chester still with the ball, and Chester breaks it the outside, now breaks it up, and he's going to be tackled on about the 43-yard line. And the clock running down in the first half. Line of scrimmage grew about the 43 of Highland. As number 56, and I missed him a minute ago in at the, I think I just dropped the clipboard. As fumble on the play, Chester picks it up. And Chester brought down there, and the Redskins going to take a timeout.
Yeah, we'll take a timeout with it. We're warmed up. Y'all stay tuned as we bring you back more Redskins football in just one moment.
On number 56, Chris D. Clark is the one I was trying to get in there playing left tackle. Fumble on the play, picked up by Chester. And Chester's going to pick up the first down with 13 seconds left in the first half. We've got a timeout by the Redskins as Redskins do get the first down.
They'll take a timeout with them.
Okay, we're back with 12 seconds to go in the first half. Redskins up to the line with a first down and 10 at the 39. Back to pass is Wellman. Wellman's passed out in the flat, and it's going to be incomplete as trying to hit Chester down there, but the pass not quite there as, boy, that's got to be like throwing a rock.
I would imagine
as cold as it is, as Wellman trying to hit Chester down the right side and is trying to come up with something here to end the first half, trying to put some points on the board as Redskins lead the ball game 2-0. Only points has come on a safety. 7 seconds to go in the first half. And Redskins up to the line now. Probably the last play. Fumble. And Redskins do recover. But the first half is going to come to an end with our score. The Redskins 2, the Highland Rebels 0.
And we'll be back with halftime festivities in just one moment. You'll stay tuned.
As Brandon Sisco kicks off the ball, ball goes out of bounds on about the 20-yard line, looks like, no? Well, I guess it's only about the 35, they say, but it's not. No, it's only about the 25-yard line. They'll take over about the 25. Mr. Cole, it's cold up here.
It is. Get readjusted here.
Get readjusted. Get ready for the second half action here. As the wind continues to get cold, I'm waiting for it to start snowing. I'm waiting for Frosty and waiting for Santa Claus and something to start coming in.
Well, it's been this cold. It can't be far off.
It's not too far off at all.
The Highland with the ball from their own 35, first and 10. Pitch back to the right side, and he's going to be dragged down back there by number 64, Pete Bounds. And penalty flag thrown on the play.
We don't want to pitch out for the river.
As Bounds drops him for a loss back inside the 35 at about the 33. Penalty flag thrown in the direction of the run, which usually indicates on the offense.
And I believe he had a face mask right there, Highland did.
Face mask against the level.
Okay, something a little bit different. Most of the time you see that penalty call on the defense, but a little bit of a different wrinkle that time by Highland as they come student body right. Yeah, they brought the tail back around, and really just a halfback and pitched it to him, and a lot of red jersey came with him, but Pete Bounds fought through him and dropped him back. It was about a 3-yard loss. But with the penalty, the ball was all the way back on the 16-yard line. So first and 25 for Highland. And give to the slot back, and he is trying to get outside. Now he is swarmed under at about the 25. Didn't think he was going to get quite that much as he was almost dragged down about the 22, but he was able to get up to about the 25, so it's going to be second down and 20. Second and 20 for the Rebels. Just started the second half. Redskins lead this ball game 2-0. The only score tonight has came on a safety on the Rebels, and Redskins on defense to start the second half. Second and 20, and it's given to the halfback. He's going to be brought down now, nearly hit by Martin, and Martin came back to being on the tackle along with Telemeyer and McFall, Malone. Martin hit him about 3 or 4 yards back, but unable to get a hold of him. And I know this weather is cold like this. We've seen some missed tackles by the Redskins that we haven't saw all year long.
Yeah, we haven't. I think
I think the weather can
make
play a factor in it, yeah. You can't move quite as well. Those muscles just don't work the same way. But they work the same way for both teams. Back to pass. This is the quarterback. Passed out in the flat, and it's going to be complete. And he's hit hard there and dropped by number 32, Chad Telemeyer. But it is complete up to the 39-yard line. So it's going to be third down now and about six. I'll make it fourth down. That's third down play. Fourth down and six for Highland. So Highland's going to be has set up in punt formation. And let's look how far the punter gets back. He's 5'10". Well, he's only about 12. Now he moves back a step. No rush. Not a very good punt. Takes a Redskin roll. Now a Rebel roll. It's going to roll dead at about the 34. So the Redskins will take over first down and 10 from their own 34-yard line. Okay, the Redskins with the ball, first down and 10 from their own 34. Casey Chester in at quarterback. Chester keeps. Chester trying to get outside. Now he cuts it up. Penalty flag thrown. Chester's still going. Chester's still going, and Chester's going to go all the way for the touchdown. But a penalty flag on the play as Chester turns in a big run, but penalty flag on the play, and it's coming back, I'm for certain. And boy, how many times we've seen that? Three times that Chester's made a big run, and it's come back because of the penalty. And that was a, let's see, 65, 66-yard touchdown run by Chester.
But a penalty thrown on the play, and it's going to come back.
That it is. Bad break. Tough break.
So a tough break for the Redskins there.
That's okay. I think Chester just got warmed up. You know, he didn't get warmed up.
That should have warmed him up right
that's
there.
Right.
That's a good run by Casey Chester, but all for naught. Let's see what the call. It's going to be a hole on the Redskins. And Coach Williams out there in the center of the field discussing it with the official. And we were talking about that the other day. That's Chester's had, I know that's a three that he's had in the last three ball games called back because of the penalty.
It'll be first down and 16 for the Redskins.
So with 9 minutes and 2 seconds left in the third quarter, did the Redskins take a timeout?
Yes,
believe,
they did.
I believe they did.
We'll take a timeout with them. Y'all see. As we're back to action here. Get ready to put it in the end zone. Am I on your court here?
Without a penalty this time, hopefully. As after the penalty, the ball is back at the 27-yard line. First down and 15. For the Redskins. Give to Martin, and Martin's up the middle, and Martin's still going. Martin fighting outside, and Martin is up close to the 40-yard line, about, maybe about the 39. It depends on where they spot it, but a good hard run by 33, Shane Martin. And the Redskins have come out a little more determined here in the third quarter to try to put some points on the board. They did on the previous play, but it all came back on a holding call. The 66-yard touchdown run called back by Casey Chester. And a good run by Chester. Second down play. Chester still with the ball. Chester cuts it up. And maybe a fumble on the play. There's a wild scramble for the ball. And let's see who come up with it. Highland says they've got it. And I think they're ruling the play dead. I think they're ruling the play dead right there. And big discussion out there.
Big discussion.
And Highland does come up with the ball. Has a big discussion whether or not the ball was blown dead. But no go as Coach Williams now going out to talk to the officials. And Coach Williams made two trips out there. And a discussion there by head coach Dave Williams. And, well, this is Highland. I think all the Redskin fans have to, all of us have been over here enough to remember that, you know, you do have a home field advantage. But Highland's going to have the ball at the 30, about the 38-yard line. So the Redskin defense is going to be called on to try to put a stop to it after the Redskins. If they could have gotten that touchdown on the board, the Redskins would have been in a little better position. But they only lead this ball game 2-0. And the Redskins' undefeated streak here on the line tonight is last ball game, last regular season game of the year. Give to the fullback, and he's brought down by number 33 Martin, number 81 McFall. But he does pick up about 4 yards on the play. Craig Boss also on that play attack with Redskins, but it's pickup of about four. So second and six, the Highland. Ball at the 34-yard line of the Redskins. Redskins need a big turnover here, need some kind of break here.
Big break.
Quarterback still with the ball, now he cuts it up, and he is swarmed down. Penalty flag thrown again. Penalty flag thrown in the direction of the pileup. So that one could go either way as he got it down to about the 30-yard line, about 2 yards short of the first down. But Highland giving ground, backing up. So I think the penalty is going to be against Highland as they discussed it with number 33, Shane Martin, the defensive captain.
Holding.
And it is a holding call against
holding.
Highland.
Holding against
the So that's going to back Highland up 10 yards. It's going to back it up to near the 40-yard line. Just a little outside the 40 of the Redskins. So a good break for the Redskins there as quite a few penalties tonight.
Quite a few. And I tell you what, a lot of turnovers. We've had five,
sure,
I believe, the first half.
As we said earlier, temperature I know has dropped a lot since we got up here, so I'd say somewhere in the mid-30s, 34, 35 degrees.
Wind chill is a factor.
Oh, yeah, the wind chill's got to be real low. It's got to be, you know, in the team. As both teams had a hard time hanging on the ball. Halfback pass. It's going to be caught and in for the touchdown. As Casey Chester batted the ball, but Highland, receiver, was able to catch it. And Highland takes the lead here on the Redskin. And that ball was batted by Casey Chester on a good defensive play. And Highland receiver was able to come down with it, though, and he took it in for the touchdown. So the Redskins find themselves behind here in the third quarter. Our score 6-2 with the extra point attempt coming up. And how important is that long run a minute ago look now?
Yeah, that's correct.
As the Redskins, instead of having a little more comfortable lead, are behind in this ball game. With 7:49 to go, the kick is blocked. Kick is blocked by the Redskins, and that leaves the score 6-2 with 7:49. It'll left to go in the third quarter.
And we'll be back as Pocahontas takes the lead in just a minute.
Number 34, Casey Chester.
Okay, Ron, the Rebels set the kickoff after the touchdown. The Redskins will trail the ball game 6-2. And it's going to be a kick taken by Malone down on the 11-yard line. Fumble now picked up by Malone. Malone cuts it up the sideline. Malone's to the 20 and out to the 30 and across to the 34-yard line. So a good run back. Malone gets it up to the, I think they're going to put it more. Yeah, more to 34. So Redskins first down and 10 at the 34-yard line. To start their drive with 7:44 left to go in the third quarter. A long time left in this ballgame. The Redskins have not been able to get a drive or sustain a drive in the ballgame. Pitch out to Cisco around the right side, and Cisco now cuts it up, and Cisco's going to be dropped after a gain of about four or five. He gets it to the, gets it near the 37-yard line. Let's call it the 38. So it'll be second down and four. Pickup of six for Brandon Cisco on the play.
And those fans are really lined up on that sideline, Jeff.
Yeah, they are. A lot of Redskin fans here, and they'd like to see the Redskins be able to punch one in down here. Pitch out by Cisco. Ball's on the ground. That's picked up by Martin, and Martin advances forward. And a good heads-up play by number 33, Shane Martin, as the ball was on the ground. And Redskins, I guess you could say that was a lucky bounce.
A lucky bounce.
But a heads-up play by Martin, and Martin was able to come up with it. It's going to be third down and about eight. So Redskins with a big third down play here, third down, 8 yards to go for a first and 10. The line of scrimmage is the 37-yard line. Casey Chester in at quarterback. Casey Chester cuts it out, and Chester picks up the first down. And Chester has crossed the 45 to about the 46. A quick burst of speed by Chester, and Chester wasn't going to be denied on that one as he took it up to the 46-yard line. We've got a smoke bomb going off on the other side of the...
Yeah, they're getting fired up over there.
Maybe somebody trying to build a fire over there as cold as it is. But the Redskins with new life here, ball at the 46-yard line, 6:16 to go in the third quarter. They trail the ball game 6-2 to the Rebels. Number 34, Casey Chester, set at quarterback. Chester with the ball, now cuts it out. Now cuts it out, and Chester's down the sidelines, and Chester's going to be dragged down at the 43-yard line, but he was able to pick up another first down. So another first down by the Redskins here. They've got the ball moving here as they've been able to put together a a good-looking drive right here on this series as Chester picks up the first down at the 43 of Highland. 6 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Chester gives to Martin, and Martin is hit and still bounces off and able to get a couple of yards on the play as he's down at about the 41.
I believe they built themselves a fire over there, Gary.
Yeah, I believe it. Somebody's built one over there.
Got one to go and keep themselves warmed up.
Okay, second down, and let's call it 9 for the Redskins from the 41. Chester with the ball. Chester keeps, and Chester's going to be tripped up. Back on the 43-yard line. Chester just tripped up by the shoe top. But that's going to make it third down and 11 for the Redskins. So just as the Redskins looked like they were moving the ball, now going to be faced with another big third down play. As it's third and 11. Third and 11 for the Redskins here. Ball at the 43-yard line. They need to get near the 33. Chester on the option. Chester still got it. Chester cuts it up, and Chester is going to be down to the 35. It's still going to be short of the first down by maybe about 2 yards. But it's going to be down at the 35,
and they're going to go for it.
So fourth down, and fourth and a long two. So a big play in the ball game for the Redskins. Key play right here, 34 Casey Chester's in at quarterback. 2 yards for the first down. Give to Martin, and Martin's off the right side, and Martin is fumbled on the play. And I believe Highland has come up with it. And they do. The Rebels come up with the ball. The Redskins, Martin fighting, trying to get that first down. And, you know, it was hard to see from here, but I believe Martin was going to be a little short of the first down. So the ball's going to be turned over to Highland. We have 3:52 to go in the third quarter. And the Redskins now back on defense. First down and 10 for the Rebels, ball at the 37 of Highland. Give to the fullback, and the fullback's loose up the middle. And he's finally cut down over there by number 10, Stephen Malone. But it's not till he gets to the 43 of the Redskins, or make it to 47. So Highland has got a first down at the Redskins 47-yard line. 3:28 to go in the third quarter. And the Redskins haven't found themselves in this position many times this year. As the Rebels are up to the line now, first down and 10. Give to the tailback, and he has sworn down a good defensive play. Bounds in there. 40 Fears. 81 McFall. Almost all that defensive front. Loss on the play of a yard. This will be second and 11. As I remind you, next week, regardless of the outcome of this ball game, Redskins are going to be at home next week for the first round of the playoff game. In a all probability, it depends on the outcome of some more games tonight, but Nashville more than likely out of the Southern AA Conference. Back to pass is the quarterback. Pass in the flat, and he's going to be dropped immediately by number 10, Stephen Malone. And a good play by number 10, Stephen Malone. It is a pickup of about 5, but Malone was right there on the spot to make the tackle in the flat. So third and 5 for Highland. As number 60, Brian Jansen, checks out. 44, Craig Balk checks in. The third down for Highland here in 5. Ball's on the ground, and the Redskins come up with it. Number 61, Chad Benson, come up with a fumble, and the Redskins have got the ball. They're saying he was down, so he couldn't advance it. But Chad Benson comes up with a big play for the Redskins as the Redskins got the ball now on the 47-yard line of Highland, first down and 10. That may be the break the Redskins needed.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
And a good Surgeville defensive front line that time caused the ball to pop loose. And number 61, senior Chad Benson, comes up with it. And the Redskins now on offense. They had a big, big break. That may have been the break the Redskins needed. As 34, Casey Chester, in at quarterback. Chester with the ball around the right side of Chester on the keeper. Chester cuts it up. Now he cuts it out. And he's going to pick up about five on the play, maybe a little more.
And we've got a Redskin down, and we'll be back in just 1 moment. Stay tuned. Hey, 41 Brent Reynolds got up, and he's okay.
Yeah, that's good to see on 41 Brent Reynolds, injured on the play, but gets up. Chester with the ball. Chester pitches to Cisco. Cisco trying to get outside, and Cisco cuts it up, and he's got the first down, I believe. He's got the first down out to the 37-yard line. And the Redskins pick up the first down. Now they've got the just inside the 37 with 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. The Redskins with the ball to Highland, 37-yard line. They trail the ball game 6-2. The Redskins' points come on a safety, and that's been the total offense, or not really the offense, that's been the total points for the Redskins. 34, Casey Chester, give to Martin, and Martin is up the middle for about 3 hard yards. He's down inside the 35 at about the 34. And I believe the Redskins just going to let the quarter run out here, but they won't have to run another play. And that's what's going to happen. So the third quarter is going to end, and the Redskins are trailing this ball game 6-2, but they've got the ball at the Highland 34-yard line. Second down and 6.
And we'll be back with more Redskins. In just 1 moment, and stay tuned. Quarter action here as Fort Collins retains the Redskins.
Okay, the Redskins with a second down and 7. Pitch out to Cisco around the right side, and Cisco now cuts it up. And Cisco is going to be down near the 21-yard line and picks up the first down. And the Redskins moving the ball now on offense at the Highland 21-yard line. Number 24, Brandon Cisco, picks up the first down as number 12, Jeremy Presley, checks out. 32, Chad Pielemeyer checks in. Number 51, Chris Hinkle, the center. The left guard is Brian Jansen, number 60. Brian Perry, the left tackle. First down, Chester with the ball. Now Chester pitches to Cisco, and Cisco is going to be dropped back on the 27, and Cisco, even though it was a lost yardage play, he did a good job of controlling the ball.
Yeah, he did.
Yes.
That could have been another turnover there.
Could have been. There's been a lot of turnovers this ball game. I'd be afraid to even start count on both sides. Yes. A lot of turnovers on a windy, windy, cold night. But it's going to be second down and about 15 yards for a first down. Pitch out to Cisco around the right side. Now Cisco cuts it up, and Cisco's going to be dropped at the 21, so he gets back to the original line of scrimmage. Make it at the 22. So third down and 11 for the Redskins. As number 10, Malone comes in, 32, Tulemeyer. Number 80, Michael Johnson checks up. Number 52, Mike Emmons, 77, Alex Phillips in on the offensive line on the right side. So a big play for the Redskins, third and 11. Chester keeps. Chester cuts it up, and Chester's going to be dropped. Maybe for a gain of about one, no more. So the Redskins now with fourth down.
11. And they're going to elect to take it.
Fourth down, so what? Even though there's 10 minutes left in the game, what should be a big, big play for the Redskins coming up. Fourth and a long 10 yards. The line of scrimmage, the 21. Back to pass is Chester. Chester's pass is going to be knocked away and intercepted. Down on inside the 10-yard line. And number 34, Casey Chester, off the option, tries to pass over or down close to the goal line. But even though that's an interception, that would have been to Highland's advantage to knock that ball down, because that was a fourth down play.
Yeah, it was.
So Highland stood up with the ball at the 21. Highland's got the ball at the 9-yard line.
9-yard line.
So a good defensive stand here by the Redskins. They could get the ball back for another shot. But clock running down, 9 minutes and 40 seconds left to go in the game. Redskins trail it 6-2 to the Rebels. Redskins undefeated on the year, Highland 7-2. And give the fullback, and he is nailed by a host of the Redskins. The 33 Martin and number 61 Chad Benson. And somebody had him low, a couple of the Redskins had him low. Number 40, Jerry Fears, number 64, Pete Bounds, getting up off the bottom of that pile. And it was a gain of maybe half a yard. We'll give him a yard on the play. The ball sitting right on the 10-yard line. So second down and 9 for Highland. And Redskin defense digging in, trying to hold in here. And this time the ball carrier gets outside. And he's going to be up to the about the 17-yard line. It's going to be short of the first down by maybe, well, it's going to be real close. It's going to be real close to a first down for Highland. I thought he was short by a yard or so. Third down and about a half a yard for a first down for Highland. About a half a yard for the first down. Give to the fullback, and he's hit hard, but I believe he's going to pick up the first down as he is up near the 20-yard line. And it is a first down for Highland as they move the ball just across the 20. Their own 20. First down and 10 for Highland. Redskin defense trying to make something happen here with 7:55 to go in the ball game. They trail it 6-2. Redskin offense unable to get in the end zone tonight. Their only points come on a safety in the first half. And Highland scored on a tipped pass. So not much scoring tonight on either side, but Highland now with the ball, and the ball carrier's hit in the backfield, and now he's going to be sworn down by the Redskins back on the 17-yard line, so a loss on the play. It's going to make it second down, and let's see, a loss of about 3. It's going to be second down and 13. Second down and 13 for Highland. Ball back on the 17-yard line. And the Redskins would like to come up with a big play here. I think it's about time for a fumble run. We haven't had one in 2 or 3 minutes. Back to pass. Here's the quarterback. Now he's being rushed. Now he throws the pass. It's going to be intercepted by Cisco. Cisco's down the sideline. And Cisco's out of bounds at the 23-yard line.
Excellent play by Brandon Cisco. There.
Number 24, Brandon Cisco, comes up with a big, big interception. And had he not stepped out of bounds, Cisco may have went all the way on that one. And boy, wouldn't that been nice.
That it would. That it would.
But the Redskins with an opportunity here from the 23, first down and 10 from the Highland 23-yard line. And the Redskins, I know, desperately want to get in the end zone. And this one could win the ball game for them if they could get in here with 6:44 left. Give to Cisco, and Cisco fights forward and gets across the 20 to about the 18. And they're going to, let's see, no, they're going to mark it a little short. It's going to be like the 19. So second down and 7. Second and 7 for the Redskins. Ball to 19. with 21 Ralph Collier comes in along with 44 Craig Baltz as the Redskins go to their power set in the backfield. 34 Casey Chester is the quarterback. Option play, Chester cuts it up, and Chester's going to get maybe one, no more. As the Redskin offense, well, I guess you credit the defense for that. The Redskins haven't been able to move the ball as well as they have been all year long. With Highland coming in with a 7-2 record, their only loss has been to Nettleton and to Corning. The big play for the Redskins, third down and six. Chester set at quarterback. Chester with the option. Chester cuts it up. Now Chester cuts it out, and Chester gets inside the 15 at the 14. It's going to be short of the first down by about 2 yards. So fourth down and two play coming up for the Redskins. Fourth and two.
As it's been one game tonight, I'll tell you.
It has. Been an unusual game. We've had a lot of unusual games this year with weather-wise and otherwise. But this could be the play of the ball game as 34th Casey Chester set at quarterback. They need a yard. Martin's got it. Martin's got it. Down close to the 11-yard line as Shane Martin just slammed the ball in there. Some good blocking by the offensive line. Number 51, Hinkle. In there, number 44, Baltz is in there as a power back along with Collier, 21. And first and 10 for the Redskins at the 12-yard line. 4:41 left to go in the ball game. The Redskins trail at 6-2 as McFall comes in. Number 80, Michael Johnson, checks out. With the ball, Chester trying to get offside, and Chester's around the sideline. It's Chester to the five, and he's in for the touchdown.
And there's no flag in the play.
Penalty flag. There's the penalty flag after the play. Depends on who it's on, but Chester took it in for the touchdown. And I believe the penalty is going to be on Highland after the play.
And it will be.
Let's see what the call is. There was a penalty flag thrown after the play. It is a touchdown. The Redskins score. Chester takes it in from 12 yards out on the option. And a good job by Chester. When Chester was down about the two, it looked like they were going to get him or knock him out of bounds. But Chester, he smelled that end zone.
Did you see him reach? I mean, he just reached for that end zone.
He sure did. And we'll talk about the penalty after the extra point attempt. For 24, Brandon Sisco to attempt the extra point.
It's
and
good.
The kick is good. And the Redskins lead this ball game by a score of 8-6.
And make it 9-6. 9-6.
We forgot the extra point, but 9-6 is our score with 4:14 left to go in the game. Okay, the kickoff's going to come from the 45-yard line of Highland. A personal foul penalty assessed against the Rebels. But Sisco's kick's going to be taken on about the 10-yard line, fumble around, and then he's going to be dropped back on the 8. And down there to make the hit was number 40, Jerry Fears, along with 24, Ralph Collier, for the Redskins. So the Redskins down defense, but Highland with 4:13 to go. And as we've seen earlier, you know, this ball game's not over till it's over.
That's right.
And Highland come up with a tip pass for their touchdown. If you remember earlier, Chester was in good position to make the play, tip the ball just like you're supposed to, but a good play by Highland, and he took it in for the touchdown. So Highland can throw the ball.
Yes, they can.
So the Redskins are going to have to be on their toes. Give to the tailback, and he has dropped down on an outstanding defensive play by number 44, Craig Baltz. And good play by linebacker Craig Baltz, number 44. And Craig Baltz has had an outstanding year for the Redskins at linebacker. He was moved to linebacker this year, and he has done an excellent job.
He sure has.
So it's going to be second down and 11 as the ball is back at about the 8. Back to pass is the quarterback. Pass is complete, and he's going to be immediately dropped again by number 44, Craig Balch. 32, Chad Tiedemeyer also over there on the play. But it is complete out to the 16-yard line. It's going to be short of the first down by, well, let's see, about a yard. So third and one. Third and one for Highland. 2:54 left to go in the game. Redskins lead it 9-6 in a hard ball game.
Hard.
And to be perfectly honest, Ron, I really didn't expect this score to be this close. Give to the fullback. He's got the first down. And although I was watching Chad Tiedemeyer there, he was calling for a cliff or something. He was knocked out of the play, and I just didn't see it. But it's a first down for Highland out at the 25-yard line. 2:36 left to go in the ballgame, and I believe Highland's got all their timeouts left, so the Redskins need to come up with a big play here and get possession of that football, as Highland has already shown they can throw it. First down and 10 for Highland. Back to pass is the quarterback. Pass is going to be intercepted by McFaul, and McFaul still on his feet. McFaul down the sidelines to the 10, the 5, touchdown. Touchdown, number 81, John McFaul. And an outstanding play by McFaul. And coach, you need to make a running back out of McFaul.
Well, he does.
Number 81 senior, John McFaul, returns it for a touchdown of about, it was about 30 yards, I guess 25 or 30 yards. And the Redskins, all at once, are on the scoreboard again with 2:04 left in the game. 15-6 our score. And Brandon Sisco, number 24, going to attempt the extra point. As number 12, Jeremy Presley, the holder. We haven't talked a whole lot about it, but we'll talk about it in a minute. As Sisco's set to attempt the extra point. The kick is up, and it looks good.
No good.
They say it's no good.
Okay.
But it'll look good, but nevertheless, the Redskins lead this ball game 15-6 with 2 minutes and 4 seconds left in the 1993 regular season, and their undefeated streak is still going. Hopefully, with only two minutes, and we'll find out.
And we'll be back in just one moment.
Kick after the big touchdown by John McFaul with 2 minutes and 4 seconds left in the game. Highland falls on the ball. He's down right there at the 23-yard line. And Highland's going to have the ball and another shot with 2:04 to go. But what that touchdown did, our score 15-6. Highland's going to have to score twice, because if they scored and then went for two for the extra point, it'd still be a 15-14 ball game.
That it would.
So that was an important extra point. The first one, all extra points are important. But one of the two, and it means Highland's going to have to score twice with less than 2 minutes to go. But the Redskins 9-0 in the year, and they're within 2 minutes of an undefeated regular season as they've come storming back here and took the lead. Back to pass is the quarterback, been rushed by McFaul, and now he's going to be dropped with a penalty flag thrown on the play. Over there, Fears, along with 51 Hinkle and 64 Pete Bounds, with a penalty flag thrown right in the direction of the run. So we'll see what the call is going to be. But don't forget next week, and Ron, I think next week, we'll talk about that in a second. The penalty is going to be against Highland, and I didn't see the call. Did he give the call? Cliff. Cliff against Highland. And next week, talking about the playoffs, like I said, in all probability, we're going to be playing Nashville or McLean, but probably Nashville, I'm told. But the Redskins will be at home for the first round of the playoffs. And something kind of interesting, the Redskins do win next week, they'll be home again for the second round. That's the way the bracket's drawn up. Back to pass, his quarterback, or his pitch man, and way down the field, it's going to be too long.
Oh, I love the tree.
Incomplete. And next week, I think, Ron, we talked about it, you're going to maybe run on the cable.
I'll throw it.
Who we're going to play and some things about the game next week. But it will be at home at good old Schoonover Stadium where it's warm.
Warm.
And hopefully it don't rain, and hopefully the weather will be good.
Yeah.
As the Redskins, boy, have had an excellent year. They're going to go 10-0 for the regular season, undefeated on the year, and they deserve it. They have really played well.
Back at home, Jeff Hoffman, he put in the electricity to keep us nice and
that's right.
Lit up, and then we got airflow with Mike Jones, but the insulation, so we're, you know, just one after the other is helping out.
Back to pass is the Highland quarterback. He's going to be dragged down. Ball's on the ground, and I don't know if they're going to rule it a fumble. No, they're going to rule it an incomplete pass.
Incomplete.
As he was dragged down back near the goal line, number 51, Chris Hinkle, come up with the ball, but they're going to rule it an incomplete pass. And Highland has got to get out to the 38-yard line for a first and 10. The line of scrimmage is going to be right at the 5-yard line. So third down and 29 yards for a first down.
It's a minute 13.
Redskins lead this ball game over the Highland Rebels 15-6, and they've come storming back here and have really showed a lot of character in this ball game as they were down and have come back and scored twice. Pass is going to be complete and out of bounds at about the 20-yard line. It's going to be well short of the first down. And that was a third down play, so it's going to be fourth down and about 10 or 12 yards to go for a first down. So they mark it down right on the 20, and they've got to get to the, 35 to 34. So fourth down and 14 yards for a first down for Highland. A minute 7 left in the game. Redskins lead at 15-6. Fourth down now. This could be more or less the last play for Highland if they don't convert here. Back to pass is a quarterback. He's been chased by balls. Now he gets the pass up in the air. It's going to be intercepted by Chester. Chester's down the sidelines, and Chester's going to go in for the touchdown. Number 34, Casey Chester, returns it for a touchdown, but a penalty flag on the play. And I'm afraid that one's coming back as the penalty flag's laying on about the 15, about the 10-yard line. And Chester returns it for a touchdown, but I bet old Casey's getting tired of these penalties.
Because
every time he scores a touchdown, it comes back. And that one's going to come back. As they're discussing it over there, it's going to be a cliff against the Redskins. That's what it's going to be. A cliff against the Redskins down on about the 10-yard line, and that's going to bring the touchdown's going to come back, but the Redskins are going to have possession of the football. That's the most important thing.
That's right.
The score really don't matter.
No.
And the Highland coach out there is upset about something.
Yes, he is. He's getting with it.
Yes.
I don't blame you.
55 seconds left in the game. And I don't know what all the commotion's about. All Cheshire did was intercept it and run it back for a touchdown. I don't see a lot of controversy in that.
I bet I don't.
And the penalty was on the Redskins. They're calling it back, so don't see a lot of controversy in that.
Not at all. Once again, folks, we'll play this back, of course, and then we'll scroll on the character generator back home to tell you exactly who will be playing in the first round of playoffs back at Schoonover Stadium. That's next week at 7:30 at home.
I believe now the playoff games may be different.
I think it's 7 o'clock, excuse me.
Okay.
7 p.m.
You'll put it on that one for us, okay?
Yeah.
But hopefully we'll get to talk to Coach Williams next week. I know it's going to be a busy week with senior Redskins getting ready for the first round of the playoffs. But we're going to try to get up and talk to Coach Williams and talk a little bit about the other team that we're going to be playing.
And we'll take time out with them. Stay tuned, folks.
Okay, Ron, first down and 10 for the Redskins. Number 14, Zach Wellman, in at quarterback. Wellman's going to go back and just fall on the ball. And he's just going to kneel down. One of the Highland players got a cheap shot. It's a perfectly legal play. A little bit unethical, but legal play. I guarantee you, Wellman, the next time he's going to duck down a little bit.
Yeah,
as Highland, you can tell, a little frustrated.
Yeah.
As they played a good game. Highlands give Redskins a good game here. Had the lead there on the Redskins, but the Redskins came back and took it to the Highland Rebels as they showed Highland this is the year of the Redskins.
That it is. Yeah, we're a 10-0 season right now.
Undefeated on the year, 10 seconds to go. And Wellman kneels down, and that's going to be the ball game. 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1, and the Redskins are undefeated for the 1993 regular season. 10-0, undefeated on the season. Undefeated on the season by the Redskins, and next week will be the first round of the playoffs. And we'll be getting that information to you next week as the Redskins will move on to the playoffs and start a whole new season over in MLS. And, boy, I'd like to say congratulations to all you Redskins, the senior high Redskins and the coaching staff, as they've done an outstanding job this year.
They have.
And the Redskins, a little bit of thing about the defense, we've talked about them quite a bit, but only had 3 touchdowns scored on the first team defense all year long, and hopefully they can carry that into the playoffs.
Yeah.
And I just say congratulations to the senior high Redskins and the coaching staff. They've done an outstanding job, and we're proud of all of them.
We're proud of all those folks kind of Redskins boys, I tell you.
And we're proud of all the fans, too.
All the fans, I'll
tell you. Well, they had the sidelines lined over there tonight.
They've done
it all year long.
They sure have. Once again, this is your Pocahontas Redskins Football Network. Y'all stay tuned for more football action as we go to playoffs in 1994. We'd like to thank those sponsors now, so y'all stay tuned.